At East Doncaster Secondary College, a highly accomplished teacher reflects on how blogs and video tutorials can be used to engage students and support his colleagues. In Year 9 Media, we introduce students to the concept of representation, exploring how women are represented in beauty magazines. Representation is the idea that what we see in the media isn't real, it's just a construction of reality. And this is a fairly abstract concept for students, so we try to demonstrate it in an engaging way by giving them some hands-on experience with photo-retouching. To do this, we use a blog and video tutorials to teach them the skills used by professional photographers. So when you see an interview with a politician, or if you see footage of something on the news, or if you see a celebrity in a magazine, what you're seeing is not the real person. You're seeing a photograph or an image of that person. In class, I give students an overview of the important ideas and concepts using a presentation on the interactive whiteboard. After demonstrating these techniques, I give them time to explore the software using written directions on the blog and video tutorials that I've recorded using screen recording software. My approach to using ICT is based on the idea that students learn differently. Students often find industry standard software a little bit daunting, and it can be a real barrier to learning. A traditional approach, which would involve taking the entire class through step by step, is often too bewildering for students who lack confidence, and it's frustratingly slow for advanced students. So having a range of resources, including written directions on the blog and videos, means that students can learn at their own pace, and I can spend more time teaching those who really need some support. One of the advantages of using a blog as the hub for our media program is that it enables students to take greater responsibility for their learning outside of class. The blog and the video tutorials have allowed me to create a flexible learning environment that exists beyond the walls of the classroom.
I show them, and then I give them heaps of time to play and to become really proficient at using these tools.
These tools not only help students, but they're also a great way to support colleagues who want to use this sort of technology in the classroom. I'll typically spend time with colleagues showing them not only how to use the software, but also the most effective ways to use it in class. And while it's great to spend time one-on-one, we're often so busy that we don't get a chance. And this is where the video tutorials really come in handy. The blog's another great way to support colleagues when they're using technology in their classrooms.
I basically used it as a springboard for other things. So we would, in the case of Photoshop, we would watch the examples and do the examples in class, and then I would set them an assignment, whether it be to beautify someone or to make someone less attractive or to transform someone.
Using the blogs and the video tutorials to guide students through the often difficult process of using industry standard software is really effective and engaging. It's also a terrific way to support colleagues and ensure consistency of practice across different classes. My blog and the video tutorials have been used not only by teachers across Australia but also overseas. The website gets over 100,000 views a year, and my videos have been viewed almost 300,000 times. And I think using technology like this is a terrific way to support not only my colleagues, but also help teachers who are working at other schools. And I'm really looking forward to developing this material, particularly video content, further in the future.
How can you work with colleagues to select and use digital resources and tools to complement teaching practice and improve student engagement? And model the use of ICT to meet the needs of diverse cohorts of students, or teach those areas of content that often constitute barriers to further learning?